This muscle is spurting babies. Biologists at Cambridge University have just discovered that females of this endangered freshwater mussel species will move to shore, attach themselves to the bank, then blast a larva-filled stream of water a meter through the air. That's 23 times their own body length. The same as you spitting babies about 40 meters or 131 feet. The larva in the jet then parasitically attach to the gills of passing fish and grow into juveniles. No other species of mussel has been seen doing this, so best of luck with the survival of your species, you baby squirtin' little freak. Vsauce, one story down, five to go. This is Mind Blow. Turn your phone into a makeshift fluorescent microscope. We owe much of what we know about cell and tissue development in the human body to fluorescent microscopes. It produces clear, beautiful images of tiny cells that help highlight and identify specific molecules and tiny biological structures. Well, a team of biologists at Winona State University in Minnesota have just figured out a way to use off-the-shelf components to turn any smartphone into a fluorescence microscope. For only about 30 bucks. Called a glow scope, it's made up of an LED flashlight, theater filters, and a smartphone. This is an amazing tool for hands-on science education. They even posted full instructions to build your own online, so you can finally study those zebrafish embryos you've got in your garage. Atoms can play baseball with chilled rubidium. A team at the Korea Advanced Institute of Science and Technology threw chilled rubidium atoms a distance of 4.2 micrometers, which would be a full kilometer for a real baseball. They dropped the temperature to 0 degrees Kelvin, just above absolute zero, and tossed it into two optical traps generated by 800 nanometer lasers. The atom pitcher wouldn't sign with the Yankees, let me tell you that. The rubidium fastball moved at 65 centimeters per second, or 1.5 miles per hour. But it's not actually about replicating baseball. Testing and refining this technology can eventually make quantum computers millions of times faster than what we have today. Now for a very special happy 4th birthday to Raid Shadow Legends, the turn-based battle game with a focus on collecting champions. I grew up getting about one video game a year in the 80s, so seeing these graphics on my phone downloaded for free is insane. There are over 650 unique champions that you can customize in billions of ways, with new champions and updates every month, and incredible boss battles. I take a Conan the Barbarian philosophy when it comes to playing Raid. Ravage your enemies, assault all bosses, impale online challengers, destroy and hear their lamentations. And to celebrate Raid's 4th anniversary, there are dedicated offers, free gifts, promo codes, events, and a brand new fusion event where you can get your hands on an anniversary-themed legendary champion. Use my link in the description or scan my QR code to get amazing bonuses, like epic champion Kellen the Shrike and super useful items. Once you're in-game, after clicking on the links, just enter promo code 4YEARSRAID for 4 legendary skill tomes and much more. So hit my link in the description or scan my QR code and come find me under the name Vsauce2Kevin. And big thanks to Raid for sponsoring Vsauce2. Feel sober instantly with a shot. Someday, maybe. Biochemists at the University of Texas have discovered that an injection of fibroblast growth hormone 21, also known as FGF21, cured mice of alcohol-induced dizziness and impairment. They recovered from alcohol 6 times faster than mice without it. And when scientists gave the shot to mice who had passed out from alcohol, they woke up 2x as fast. The hormone doesn't actually get rid of the alcohol in the subject's bloodstream. It just stops it from impacting their nervous system. So you're still drunk, you just don't feel drunk. Researchers say their discovery could be useful for treating loss of consciousness and impaired mobility among people with acute alcohol poisoning. But no word yet on when you'll be able to order one bourbon, one scotch, and one FGF21. The T-1000 Terminator begins with this snail. Engineers at Carnegie Mellon University in Pittsburgh have created a breakthrough in Softbiotics, a flexible, self-healing, liquid metal-filled organogel with metal-like conductivity that can support electrical motors and digital electronics. So far, they've used this incredible advance to create this snail. It may move slowly, but when researchers cut the circuits that powered its locomotion, the organogel healed itself and restored almost 70% of the lost power, making it the first of a new generation of robots with integrated regenerating sensing movements and probably a desire to terminate snail John Connor. Ancient Romans really wanted this dead guy to stay dead. The tomb of an Imperial Roman noble family was recently excavated by archaeologists at Catholic University Leuven, and it contained a body sealed with an unheard of 3 separate protections to stop them from coming back from the dead. First, the body was burned inside the tomb and left there, which is extremely rare in Roman burials. Second, it was nailed down with dead nails that had been intentionally bent and disfigured, a known ancient charm against evil magic. Finally, they sealed him under a layer of quicklime covered in heavy tiles to stop the body from rising again. No Roman burial has ever been found with all 3 of these ancient protections in one place. So let me know what you think this guy did to earn an unprecedented level of zombie proofing. And now a news report on the Nintendo Entertainment System from 1988.
Should parents buy these games at all? The National Coalition Against Television Violence thinks they shouldn't, because they say they're bad for kids.
She doesn't like
this girl's mother doesn't like the game.
Because she thinks that you're going brain dead while you're watching it.
Maybe you will be brain dead from staring at this thing all the time.
No.